Welcome back to Linux Network. Fedora 41 Beta introduces a variety of new features and improvements that aim to make the system more efficient, modern, and user-friendly. This update brings several important changes, especially for developers, gamers, and those who rely on the system for professional use. So, let's break it down. Fedora Linux 41 marks the official end of support for Python 2. If you're not familiar, Python 2 is a popular programming language used by developers all over the world. However, Python 2 is an older version that has not been actively developed for several years now. Most modern software now uses Python 3, which is more secure, faster, and better supported. In Fedora 41, Python 2 is being removed from the system, except for PyPy, which is a special implementation of Python. If any software you rely on still uses Python 2.7, which is the final version of Python 2, you'll either need to update it to use Python 3 or find a replacement. For developers who still need to test software with Python 2, Fedora suggests using containers, which are like isolated mini versions of older Fedora releases that can still run Python 2 without affecting the main system. This change is part of a broader push by the open source community to move away from outdated software and ensure that everything's running on Fedora is modern, safe, and well-maintained. If you're a regular user who doesn't develop software, you'll likely won't notice this change, but developers will need to be aware of it and adjust accordingly. For many users, especially those who game or use software for AI and machine learning, having good support for NVIDIA graphics card is essential. NVIDIA offers a proprietary driver that is often necessary for these tasks, but in previous versions of Fedora, it was tricky to install because of issues with Secure Boot. Secure Boot is a security feature that is enabled by default on many modern laptops. It ensures that only trusted software can run during the boot process, which prevents malware from being loaded. Until now, Fedora Graphical Software Manager, GNOME Software, didn't include an easy option to install the NVIDIA driver because of Secure Boot. This made it difficult for users who needed the NVIDIA drivers but didn't want to disable Secure Boot. However, with Fedora Linux 41, that's changing. Fedora is bringing back the option to install the NVIDIA drivers directly through GNOME software, and it will now work even if Secure Boot is enabled. This is a huge benefit for anyone using Fedora for gaming, AI development, or any workload that requires CUDA. CUDA is a technology used in NVIDIA cards for tasks like deep learning. It's also a great improvement for users who want a smooth, secure system that just works out of the box. You'll no longer need to jump through hoops to install the NVIDIA drivers if you're using a laptop with Secure Boot. Fedora uses a package manager called DNF to install, update, and remove software. In Fedora 41, DNF is getting a major update to version 5. The DNF package manager is important because it's how Fedora users interact with the software available in Fedora's repositories. The new version of DNF is faster, smaller, and more efficient, meaning you'll spend less time waiting for software to install or update. One of the best parts of this update is that while DNF 5 brings many technical improvements under the hood, you won't need to change how you use it. The basic commands stay the same. If you've used Fedora before, you're already familiar with the process of installing software via DNF install or updating with DNF update. Those commands still work exactly as before, but they will now run faster and use fewer system resources. However, as with many major updates, there are some changes that may not be compatible with older software or workflows. If you're a power user who like to dig into details, it's worth checking out the DNF 5 documentation to see if any of these changes will affect you. While DNF tool is the tool that most Fedora users interact with, it's built on top of another system called RPM. RPM is the low-level tool that manages the actual software packages in Fedora. In Fedora 41, RPM is also getting an update to version 4.20. Most regular users won't see any immediate change from this update, but it's an important improvement for Fedora developers. This new version of RPM brings new features that make it easier to manage packages and ensure that everything runs smoothly in Fedora. Over time, these changes will make Fedora more reliable and improve the overall experience for users. One of the most interesting updates in Fedora 41 is progress towards reproducible builds. Reproducible build means that if you take the source code for a package and rebuild it, the resulting software will be exactly the same as the original package. This is important for security and reliability because it ensures that the software you're running hasn't been tampered with. In Fedora 41, most packages will now be reproducible thanks to a post-build cleanup that has been integrated into the RPM build process. This is a big step forward for Fedora project and for open source software in general. If you're a developer or someone interested in how software is built, this is an exciting development that will make Fedora more secure and trustworthy. Fedora is introducing a new command line tool called Fedora Repo Query. This tool makes it easier to search the Fedora EPL, ELN, and CentOS Stream packages repositories. For developers and power users who frequently need to search for packages, this tool will make the process faster and more efficient. The tool works by wrapping the existing DNF repo query command, but with a few improvements. It separates cache repository data by repository name, which speeds up querying when you're working with multiple repositories. This tool will be especially useful for Fedora developers who need to find specific packages quickly. One of the exciting new spins of Fedora 41 is the KDE Plasma Mobile spin. Fedora spins are alternate versions of Fedora that come with different desktop environment or use cases. This new spin brings the KDE Plasma desktop, which is normally used on laptops and desktops, to mobile devices like phone, tablets and 2-in-1 laptops. This means that Fedora will now be available on more devices than ever before. If you're a fan of KDE Plasma or just want to try something different on your phone or tablet, the KDE Plasma Mobile spin is a great option. It's also a promising step towards making Fedora more versatile and accessible across different types of hardware. For users who prefer a lightweight desktop environment, LXQT is getting a major update to version 2.0 in Fedora 41. LXQT is known for being fast and using very little system resources, making it a great choice for older or low-power machines. The big change in LXQT 2.0 is that it has been fully ported to Qt 6. A modern version of the Qt framework that powers the desktop. This update also brings experimental support for Wayland and the newer display server protocol that is set to replace the older X11. Wayland offers better security performance and smoother graphics. With LXQT 2.0, Fedora users will get the best of both worlds, a lightweight desktop that's also modern and future-proof. Finally, Fedora 41 introduces a brand new spin called the Miracle Window Manager. Miracle is a tiling window manager that is built on the Mir Compositor library. A window manager controls how windows are displayed on your screen, and tiling window manager are popular with power users because they automatically arrange windows in a grid. What makes Miracle special is that it's designed to work seamlessly with Wayland, making it a great choice for users who want a modern, fast, and secure desktop environment. Miracle also supports floating windows for when you don't want everything to be automatically tiled. And it has great support for Nvidia graphics cards, which is important for users with high-end GPUs. The new spin is aimed at providing a high-quality Wayland experience across a wide range of devices, including low-end ARM and x86 machines. Fedora Linux 41 will be the first distribution to offer a spin based on Miracle, making it the go-to option for anyone looking to try out this new window manager. Fedora Linux 41 Beta brings a lot of exciting changes that will make the system faster, more secure, and more versatile. From the removal of Python 2 to the introduction of new spins like KDE Plasma Mobile and Miracle, there's something for everyone in this release. Whether you're a developer, a gamer, or just someone who loves using Linux, Fedora 41 offers a lot of improvements that are worth checking out. And as always, if you find this video useful, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.